All right, you legends, welcome back to the Assassin's Creed playthrough. I have to really apologize. I played an hour session yesterday. I have all my audio. Everything's good. I forgot to hit the record button on the capture program. So we've lost about an hour of this playthrough. But this is a long playthrough anyway, so there's going to be tons more content. I apologize for those of you that are really following along with the story. What happened was I made my way to basically kind of like a training facility for assassins that, I think he's my uncle. He had, created. We might see some more of that, but I rescued my sister, and my mother. This is the place that I made it to here. We did a little bit of training, and, I ended up killing the guy that I fought in the very beginning, the younger guy. I ended up killing him. So it's kind of where we are at the moment. At this point in time during the playthrough, I've actually had, see if we can get something here. I've had some chances to actually see a lot of the feedback and respond to now the feedback you guys have left. I'm only going to stick with the main missions, all right, just so we can make it through.
And here he is, our campione Ezio.
Oh, hey, Ezio! I see you've wasted no time starting the celebration.
And why not? You've done us a great service, Nipote. With Vieri dead, La Toscana will grow quiet once more. Do you know what that means?
Passa lavorare.
Si passa tutto il giorno a bere.
E a puttane. What? It's true.
Come, Ezio. Walk with me.
Yes, uncle.
Yeah, we'll do that. This is part of the main mission.
To another. The Spaniard.
He is Rodrigo Borgia, one of the most powerful men in all of Europe, and leader of the Templar Order.
Which makes him responsible for the murder of my father and brothers.
Yep, we're not even going to read about that and stuff anymore.
You too, given the chance.
Then I must stand against him if I wish to be free. But not until every other Templar has fallen to my blade. Father's list will guide me.
I'll talk some more when
Where
they're
will
done.
You go next?
Firenze. Francesco De Pazzi will share the fate of his son.
A sensible next step. No doubt he intends evil for the city. All right. That's enough grim talk for one night. I'll be in my study if you need me.
I shall read the letter my uncle gave me.
So there's the glyph thing we were talking about. Now we need to get to that letter. It looks like, actually I can probably climb up here. Yeah, there we go. And then also I'm going to make the, try to make the episodes longer. I'm going to try to make them 30 minutes long an episode. So that's what we're going to try to do there. One of 100 feathers collected.
Look familiar?
Oh, they're codex pages.
Yes. Your father managed to find and translate a few before he... Here. This is not your father's work. Someone else has translated it.
Leonardo da Vinci, a friend.
Do you see the way the words cross from one page to the next?
There is something underneath it all. Some kind of map. Where is it supposed to lead?
Your father and I managed to make out bits of a prophecy scrawled across these pages. It was written by an assassin like us, who long ago held a piece of Eden. His name was Altair. He spoke of something powerful and ancient hidden beneath
the land. We remember him.
What is it?
What indeed? Solving that little mystery is exactly why we collected these pages.
Then let me help. It's time I take on my father's work. All of it. I start with the page I took from Vieri. Leonardo will decode it for us.
Bene. Return here when time permits, and we'll add it to the wall.
Awesome. So that's That is part of the main storyline here, I would assume. Put a page revealed your map by viewpoints. Use the map to locate objectives, side quests. You can also set your own GPS markers in the Animus Tech desktop. What is the, oh, I need to, it looks like get to this letter deal here. Oh god, where are you trying to climb to? Why is my income zero? Let me check and see what that, so my destination is right there. Is that below me? I guess. Come on, homie. Where's the thing on the outside now? Oh, that's where we need to go. Climb up right there, homie, yo. There you go. If you don't climb up the top of that thing. Yeah, it's a big bird up there. There you go, Ezio. There you go, Ezio. Get up to the top, do a little synchronization action. So yeah, I'm super sorry about jacking up that last recording. Really, I am. I didn't know, but there's nothing I can really do. I mean, I can't replay it, I don't think. Collect the 4 philosophical codec pages. And I had already recorded the commentary. One codex collected. Alright, so find these codex pages and take them to Leonardo. So there they are. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright. So we're good. We're on with the main mission here. And like I said, this is what I'm gonna try to stick to for the sake of time. Ideally, I would like to finish all these Assassin's Creed games before the new one comes out, but I don't even think that's even logical. I still have 2 other full games to play, and I just started this one, you know. We have Brotherhood and Revelations to still play before getting to Assassin's Creed 3. I guess the question's going to come up if, do I play Assassin's Creed 3 as soon as it comes out, or and record it and upload it and then come back to the others? What is this? Oh, it's a feather. Nice. Even though I'm not going to do that, I consider that a side mission, you know. The question is, do I, when Assassin's Creed 3 comes out, just jump into it and play it, or do I wait until I've finished all of the other Assassin's Creeds? That's where we're gonna have a problem here. So here's where we need to go. Highlight that beast on our map. There it is. Man, this place is miserable feeling. It's so dark and dead. I hope that I can get over here. Yeah, there we go. Oh, God. If I drop off that, am I going to die? Let's try it. Nope. Nice, very nice. Alright, here we go. About need a horse, don't I? So we're going to collect this last codex page, and then I think we're going to head over to find Leonardo da Vinci and get him to translate, decipher them. will be good. Oh, and there's my horse. Perfect. Perfect. Alright, so now, top on this legend. Decoding force will increase your maximum health. Money, honey, money, honey. Let's see where that, Oh, they're wanting me to take them. Will increase your maximum health. Alright, so we need to go check on Claudia now. That horse can run on rocks. Give me a break.
Hey, hey!
Really? Alright, Assassin's Creed developers. I'm gonna need y'all to make a horse that can run on rocks. Cause that's kinda shitty. I hope I can take you into this place. Yeah. Oh, nope. Alright, Assassin's Creed, I'm gonna need y'all to make it so I can take my horse into the spot. Just turning on the turn on that eagle vision real quick. No big deal. Alright. Why to speak to Claudia? I'm gonna jack something from here real quick. Why can't I get that box?
Salute, Claudia.
Our uncle is un mostro. This is outrageous.
What's happened?
He's making me work. If father was here, I'd never be stuck behind a desk like this.
And what are the terms of this supposed enslavement?
Since someone decided we're going to stay here, Tio Mario suggested we try and find the money to repair the villa. Problem is, there isn't any.
I bet I can bring in some money.
Oh, great. More work for me. Well, benissimo. If you start paying for improvements to the town, I'll keep track of them in this book. And since I have nothing better to do, I'll also make note of any objects you bring in from the outside. If you actually get this place up and running, travelers might visit and spend money. Although I doubt anyone will want to come this far out of the city. But if they do, I'll keep the money we make in this chest. You're going to have to show up to take it to the bank yourself. Because when it gets full, I'm just going to take the extra cash for myself. Capito?
Deal.
Completion, 1%. What is all of this? Wow, I guess that's part of the main mission. Come to collect money from... Alright, talk to the villa's architect now. Oh, what's up, homie? Oh, that's a model of the city. That's pretty sick.
Buongiorno. Is there something wrong?
Yes, Sir Mario hired me to deal with this mess, but I'm an architetto, not a miracle worker. Without money, I can't fix any of these buildings.
And if someone brought you money?
Then we'd be in business. You must be Serezio. Am I right?
Uncle, I like this architetto.
He gets very observant when he can smell money.
If you want to fix up this town, I'm going to need it. I have a price list here for new shops and renovations. Just bring me gold, make a choice, and I'll begin at once. If I build you a shop, you, as the landlord, can purchase goods there at lower rates. If you invest more money in the shop, you get an even greater discount. As for renovations, well, you'll be bringing the town and villa back to life. As Sir Mario tells me, that was very important to your great-great-grandfather. Plus, when you buy shops and renovations, you'll be increasing the number of people who visit, causing your income to increase. So, let's take a look, shall we?
Art merchant. Bank. Yeah, all this stuff is so beat up. Blacksmith. So what do I have? I have 8,900 available. I can renovate some of the stuff now. Now the question is, I wonder what the brothel. Let's do, okay. So the mines will bring us, I'm going to hold off on the blacksmith. I'm going to hold off on these things up here. I'm not worried about those. Let's get these things out of the way. We'll start with the brothel. And we'll start with the church, right? So they'll kind of balance each other out, right? You know? Yeah, there we go. Let's see what else we have money for, if we have money for anything else. Church is good. That's 3,000, 3,000, 4,000. Okay. And I guess you don't can't do. Okay, so that's it. So we're good. Sweet. Nice. Value went up. And now it looks like we're going back to talk to my uncle. Speak with Mario in his office. Sada, wada. It's a me, Mario.
Ezio, my boy. I think it's time I showed you something.
Show me, homie. Oh, I like secret passageways. What? Who left that lantern burning back there? Oh, God, this is like the Batcave, dude. Call me Ezio Wayne. Holy mother, what is this?
This is the sanctuary. It was built by my great-grandfather to honor the memory of the Assassin Order and protect its secrets. Look around. These are the assassins who guarded the freedom of humanity when it was most threatened. And this is the armor of Altair. Little is known about Altair's life, but his armor is light and very strong. I'd give it to you, but I don't know how to retrieve it. My great-grandfather told me it would remain locked away until all its protectors were made whole. I heard rumors of crypts located throughout Italia. Hidden tombs filled with treasure, where these six were moved centuries ago. Maybe they have something to do with it. In my younger days, I sought the six myself, with no success. Perhaps you will have better luck.
That'll be sick, yeah. That'll be fun.
In order to achieve perfect synchronization with Ezio, you have to get that armor.
I'd love to get that armor. She poisoned Alexander the Great. So I need to find all this stuff for these pedestals. Oh, that dude's like me, Darius, Persian assassin with the hidden blade. Mongolian assassin with the bow and arrow. Alright, I think we're good here. And I'm guessing that... Alright, yep, that's what we gotta do, is we gotta find all that stuff. So... Now, roll out. Get on with our missions here. I'm not going to go around. I see on my mini-map there's a little feather there. I'm not going to run around collecting feathers and stuff. That's just a side mission that's going to stretch this thing out. So, we're going to stick with the main objective, which is an exclamation mark there. Oh, God, dude. It looks dismal out here. What is this cat? No, I don't need to practice combat. We just need to get on with the missions, baby. That's what we're doing. Moving right on through. Just synchronization point up there. Dude, you better watch out who you're bumping into. Where's my horse? There you are. Alright, here we go. On our way. I'm guessing we're heading to Leonardo now to take the codex pages. I'm not sure at the moment, but hope you guys are enjoying this. Yeah, we'll go to Florence. I guess that's where we're going. Shoot, I should have looked, made sure that's where we're going. I might need to get a new computer to render out all these things, these big 30-minute sessions. Is this where I was supposed to go or no? Because it's just now building this city, like it's the first time I've been here. Yep, I guess this was where, this was exactly where I needed to go. Hell yeah. Leonardo.
Ezio, you are still alive. Look at this place. The past 2 years have been kind to you.
But you are not the same at all.
I've been going for 2 years.
I was hoping you might be able to help me with something.
Anything for you, my friend. Ha ha! You found another one. How exciting! This one is tricky to break. Clever in its use of ancient languages. Maybe if I just... Oh, it seems to be a manual of sorts for different assassination techniques.
May I see it?
Wait, what's that? It's not so much a design this time, just a series of sketches. What to make of all this? Of course, and why not? What an inspired idea.
Can you make it for me while I try what's in that manual fragment?
Take it. I'll have my assistant set up some dummies for you to practice with. Hey, Vincenzo!
Vincenzo? Yeah, let's do it. That's part of the mission, baby. So it looks like we're gonna do some more training stuff here. All right.
By order of the Signoria, all merchants trading in unconverted bullets.
Guessing we need to get up here first, right? Oh, that was dirty. Assassinate from a low. Assassinate in high or low profile. Doing so in low profile reduces the risk of. Air assassinate. Oh, that's sick, too. Perform an air assassination with your hidden blade equipped. Lock on to target and press X. So we gotta get in here. Oh, this was something you couldn't do in the first one. Oh, that's so gangster. Wow, disposing of the bodies. That was dope.
I've done it. Come quickly. Look.
What you got for me, homie?
Take it. Try it.
Thank you, Leonardo.
Non c'è di che.
There's someone I need to see while I'm here. I cannot approach him publicly. Would you know a way?
La volpe.
The fox.
Shh.
Capisco. But do you know where a fox might roam?
Perhaps near the mercato. Where the thieves dwell. Sta attento, amico.
Sweet! Yeah, dude, my dude is becoming a serious assassin right now. Let's check and see if there's anything here we can get. Uh-oh.
Indeed.
We need to start getting
my
some.
My clients are generally much known.
We need to start getting some more money here. climb up to the top. It's not going to hurt to sink these places. They're just going to help us find more things along the way here. Races. Oh, I'll race somebody any day of the week, homie. Assassinate this homie over here. Oh, there's a group of them. Here we go. Fox hunt locate. Somewhere near Mercato Riccio. Your target is in gold.
His shadows are his element. His nerves are made of steel.
There he is. Dude, get off me.
What? My pouch.
Oh,
my money.
Your money. I don't have your money.
Oh, you're gone, dude.
Get back here.
Make me.
Speed attack with the person you're chasing.
You're making a big mistake, my friend. Enough of this!
Got him, coach. Football skills coming into play,
baby. I really
baby.
Have no interest in hurting you. So give me back my money and we'll call it even.
Not so fast.
What do you want? Who are you?
They call me many things. Murderer. Tagliagole. Thief. But you may call me La Volpe. At your service, Messer Ezio.
How do you know my name?
It is my business to know everything in this city. Isn't that why you're here?
Indeed. I need to find someone. To know where he'll be before even he does.
Who?
Francesco De Pazzi.
There's word on the street of a caravan just arrived from Roma. A secret meeting at sunset tonight. You can learn something of Francesco's whereabouts there.
Do you know where it is to be held?
Ma certo. Let me know when you are ready, and we'll go. Ah, yes. Here is your money.
Alright, so... Wow, they just gave me back my money. So, that's going to be the end of this session. We'll catch up with you guys in the next session here, where we're going to find the father of the looks like the guy that we killed in the a couple episodes back. So I'll see you guys there.